Hello, my name is Sonia Verdugo Castro, and I am going to present the work called Interviews of Spanish Women in STEM, a multimedia analysis about their experience co-read with my colleagues Alicia García Holgado and Maricruz Sánchez Gómez. The labor market currently requires more qualified professionals. However, when it comes to locating and hiring new professionals for STEM areas, there is no equality between men and women. Women represent a significantly lower percentage than men in the professional field of STEM areas. This is because women are enrolled at lower rates than men in STEM. One of the leading causes of this is the persistent ungender roles which chronicle horizontal segregation. Women seem to lose interest in higher education in STEM as they grow older, confirming the lack of equipment problem. Women complete their higher education studies at lower rates than men. Of those who do finish these studies, only a few end up working at it. The study presented in this paper is a part of the project WSTEM Building the Future of Latin America, Engaging Women into STEM. It is a research project basis on interviews to analyze the experience of women working in STEM areas through the multimedia analysis of the interviews collected in Spain. The methodology used in the study was a qualitative approach. Interviews were recorded with 21 professional women from the STEM sector. The work aims to analyze what has been and is the experience of women professionals in the areas of STEM. For this reason, both the recording of the videos and the subsequent analysis have respected and studied the subjective perception of the women participants about the field of study. The research questions that have been worked on are, what has been the experience of professional women in their educational and professional field, and what is your perception of the representation of women in higher education in the STEM sector? For the study, the focus was on how they decide to join in the STEM sector, what the lines of work they develop, who encouraged them to do so, and what message they will convey to other women in the future. As can be seen from the interviews and analysis of these women, some of them were really attracted to studies in STEM. However, other women were not so clear about it. Some of them hesitated until shortly before making the final enrollment in their studies. Some were interested in professions such as nursing or the fine arts, which are generally feminized educational sectors. In the end, however, all 21 participants were encouraged to take STEM. Some of them commented that they were afraid and didn't act of courage. As to whether anyone spared them, the study found that the family and social context had an influence. Some did indicate that they don't know have any reference or had any, but no female ones. However, others stated that they have been influenced by female teachers, mother, fathers, brothers, and sisters. In addition, the different women who have participated in the study highlight their great passion for the work they do, as well as for the teaching and research. Finally, they are often aware of the bias-based reality that exists in STEM studies. They all send message of encouragement to women to let themselves be guided by their true vocation when it comes to making decisions. Thank you very much for your attention.